So Nicki Minaj, who I adore, along with my beloved Beyonce Knowles, just released their new song titled Flawless. Now, this is the remix, so it wasn't the one that was on Beyonce's album. If you want to hear it, you can go to the meatmagazine.blogspot.com website. I posted it up there, along with the Anaconda record. I just wanted to give my opinion on the track. I will not be reviewing every single lyric. However, I will tell you what I think about the overall sound of the song and point out some of the notable lyrics that I think will get people talking. So Beyonce sings first, and Queen B said, quote, "Sometimes shit goes down when there's $1 billion in the elevator." Of course, this was a reference to the infamous elevator fight when her smoking hot sister Solange Knowles attacked her husband Jay-Z. Now, I wasn't surprised to hear her reference such a popular and current event. I mean, it was wise to do so, because people will surely talk about it and they'll reference it in headlines and on blogs. It'll be mentioned in newspapers and broadcasts. So kudos to Beyonce for being brave enough to say that. And extra kudos for the $1 billion reference. You need to remind these thoughts of who the queen is. Speaking of thoughts, Queen B went on to say this in the song. She said, and I quote, "These thoughts can't clock me nowadays." Now, I thought that was a good one, because it's funny just to hear Beyonce say that word for some reason, and it made for an interesting part in the song. Plus, you know, with the news of those groupies coming backstage and trying to mess around with Jay-Z and them being married and everything, it's like, I mean, what are they thinking? Jay-Z has Beyonce to go home to. Enough said. So then Beyonce goes on to say, and I quote, "Mama taught me good home training. My daddy taught me how to love my haters. My sister told me I should speak my mind. My man made me feel so god fine." Well, touche, Miss Knowles. I guess we all know who's on top. Her mother taught her how to treat people. Her dad taught her how to maneuver in a room full of vultures. Her sister taught her how to stand up for herself when appropriate. And her husband made her feel beautiful and secure. Now, if that doesn't scream winning, I don't know what does. Now, let's take a listen to Nicki Minaj's verse. Some of the things that she said that stuck out to me were when she said, quote, "Mayday, mayday, earth to bitches. Smack these hoes on they ass like we birthing bitches." Wow. Now, I got a really good laugh out of that. That was a whole lot of cussing, but it was funny, and the fact that it's true makes it even better. Now, another standout lyric from Nicki Minaj is when she said, quote, "Throw that ass back, I be on my frisbee." Now, I love that line. I mean, anytime Nicki mentions the elephant in the room, I smile. Now, as far as production goes, it's pretty good. And while it could have been better, it does sound a lot better than most music that's out right now. The song will last the summer. You know, it's not a classic, but it is a hit record in the making, and I will surely play it myself from time to time. So now that I got the good parts out of the way, I just wanted to talk about the bad parts, because I have two major qualms. Number one, Beyonce's vocal performance in some of the song is done in that current, quote, urban musical styling of sounding mentally challenged or southern or country, which is the same thing. It's like, you know, Beyonce sounds like a blaxploitation film in some of this song, as well as some of her other records, because she employs that whole dumbed down southern thing of making your words sound really, really dumb. I guess it's supposed to be cute and fun and catchy, and doing it in a southern accent, and to me it just sounds mentally challenged. And I'm offended when I hear people do that. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go listen to some Iggy Azalea. And you'll have plenty of it. Now, to me, it doesn't sound good. And thankfully, she didn't do it for the duration of her verse, as it would have completely ruined the song. Now, for the record, just because you're from the South doesn't mean you have to be dirty nor sound dirty. So I wish Beyonce would stop that. Now, number two, my other qualm was the subject matter and overall content. My only other issue was that the fact that these two young women are so powerful in the music industry as well as the world, and I would prefer to hear them do something that's more positive than make a song about speaking about mediocre subjects in mediocre ways. I mean, don't get me wrong, the song is okay and everything, and it's a quote fun record, but at the same time, with music being in its worst state ever in 2014, we really need some depth. So please dig deep, ladies. Dig deep. I give the song a 3 out of 5. Let me know what you think about it below, and be sure to subscribe to the Meat Magazine YouTube channel. Visit meatmagazine.blogspot.com. What do you rate it? Oh, one more thing. Stop expecting Beyonce and Nicki Minaj to be your child's role model. It's not their job.